Russian citizens who fled their homes amid fears that fighting may spread. This is in the Belgorod region today, where 11,000 people have been told to move. It comes after more than 70,000 were evacuated from the neighboring Kursk region. That's where Ukraine launched its lightning advance. People's surprise at the events as they unfolded was clear.
My husband kept running to the cellar. On the first day, I ran to the cellar. Then I couldn't. I was in my room. I lay huddled up, and it went bang, bang, bang.
The attack started nearly a week ago, with elite Ukrainian forces heading over the border into the Kursk region. Their advance is here in yellow. In some cases, they've been operating 20 miles inside Russia. The plan seems to be to draw Russian forces away from the areas in red inside Ukraine, where Moscow had been making steady advances. These burnt-out Russian military vehicles are one indication of how far Moscow was taken by surprise. But it's promised a tough response to what Vladimir Putin has called a major provocation, and it's sending troops into the region.
The battle to come, and this battle has only just started, but the battle to come in this Kursk pocket will be measured in days and weeks, not weeks and months, because the Russians will not allow this to stand. They will put into this pocket whatever it takes to snuff it out, whatever it takes, because they, you know, whatever happens in Ukraine is less important than what happens on the Russian border.
And inside Ukraine, the brutal war of attrition between the two sides continues, carrying with it risks. This is the Zaporizhia nuclear plant, where a fire broke out. Ukraine blamed occupying Russian forces, while the Russians blamed Ukraine for the blaze. Ukraine's incursion into Russia is a bold but risky move. It has changed the dynamic of the war for the moment, but the outcome remains uncertain. Gordon Carrera, BBC News.